Hello everyone, and welcome to the first trial of Danganronpa 2. So, we already set the skills up. Looks like you can also change the difficulty if you wanted to. We're just gonna jump into things, so I'm not sure how much time we have to do the whole trial. It's probably gonna be long, and I've been told there is a break in between, so we might only do half.
Now then, let's begin with a simple explanation of the class trial!
Okay.
Oh no!
Whoa. What happened to her? Well, I guess we'll see.
Trial, you will present your arguments for who the killer is, and vote for who done it! If you vote correctly,
this seems kind of familiar.
Then only the blackened will receive punishment. But I'll punish everyone besides the blackened.
I'm getting a bit ahead of myself already.
That person will earn the right to leave this island.
Such a cruel rule.
Yeah, so essentially it's the same as the first game.
Before we begin, I'd like to confirm one thing. Is there really a killer among us?
Really? You're still going with that?
Most definitely. There's no doubt that the Blackened is lurking among you. Such a sad state of affairs, isn't it? By the way, this class trial is gonna be 100% fair, so there's no need to worry.
Really? Just like the first game?
I guess we'll see. I hate favoritism and prejudice. Well, not as much as I hate Monami, of course.
What?
You hate me that much?
Now, let's begin!
You're telling us to begin, but what are we supposed to do?
You have to find the killer.
No complaining, let's just settle this with our fists.
I'm not sure if that's the best way.
Were you even listening to the rules?
No one listened.
Didn't that Byakuya bastard get killed in the dining hall, huh? Then everyone there is a fucking suspect.
Yeah. What you're really trying to say is that you're not the killer, right?
No shit. You guys went off on your own and started killing each other. This has nothing to do with me.
Well, I think he's right. That has nothing to do with him.
Huh? What does that mean?
Anyway.
That one of the others killed someone.
About the most pressing issue on our minds. The most pressing issue on our minds?
And what is that, pray tell?
Where we found the body. It's very strange to find a body underneath the table.
I guess? I mean, it's strange to find it anywhere, I suppose, but this game's probably gonna become normal.
Then, let's start with that mystery.
The reason why Byakuya's body was discovered under the dining hall table... We can start with that, but ultimately we need to find out who murdered him. Yeah, that's
true.
More of the point. It doesn't matter why he was underneath there. If we can't do that... No, thinking about if is a waste of time. We have to do this no matter what. The most important thing is finding the killer. So class trial has finally started. From this point on, I'll provide simple tutorials at every important moment. I'm sorry, but please excuse my ear-tainting rudeness. What? As things progress during each class trial, you'll engage in a number of non-stop debates. We know about that already. During these discussions, all of your classmates will speak one after the other without any breaks. It's up to you to reveal any lies or mistakes contained within their statements. This means you'll have to use your truth bullets to refute what they say. Out of all the truth bullets you find during your investigation, only the relevant ones will be loaded into the truth cylinder. Use the left stick to move the reticle and fire with the... What button is that?
I don't know.
There's no button like that on my controller. What am I supposed to be looking at? Hold on. What was it in the last game? I don't remember now.
Wasn't it A?
It's a fire? I think it was like either X or Y. But I don't remember which. Damn it. The hell was that? Pay close attention to each statements, each character's statements, and choose your truth bullets to blast the right ones.
I think Y was to load up the...
Holding Y would, like, load... No, oh, you mean memorize.
Yeah.
I meant memorize. You mean just change the bullets in the chamber. Right? Is that what you're saying?
No. But that was also what Y was for.
It was one of them. Note that if you run out of time, you'll automatically fail, so please be careful. Hopefully you can check once the thing... Yeah. And maybe they'll tell
Good
the
idea.
Accurate controls. Can I do it now? Okay, let's see. Well, where is shoot?
Maybe because it's not. This is still a discussion.
I guess I have to finish this discussion, and then I'll say.
Hopefully.
Let's see, make your argument. I want to check now. Hold on. Well, there's a couple. Blood stain on the table. That's how we know he was killed under there. That's what they want to say. Okay, yeah, here we go. Why is the fire the truth bullet?
Oh, sorry.
No, that's what I thought it was. Which one? A, B, X, Y. Okay. I always have to memorize this off the controller. I don't know why I didn't say it in that one spot there. It's weird. Oh, wait, do we have access to the other stuff already? Like the silencer and everything? Are you supposed to know that?
I don't know.
Well, I don't see anything, so maybe we don't just yet.
His body was underneath the table at the very back.
Just want to see. Yeah, that's the blitz in the truck bed. Okay.
After the killer murdered Byakuya, they probably moved the body there.
No.
No. It's probably going to be the blitz under the table.
Yeah.
Obviously, by hiding the body, they tried to delay its discovery. Like a dog burying a bone.
You're so cheerful about that. Huh? What he just said was strange. It clearly contradicts the information I know. Yeah, I think it's going to be the bloodstain.
It is. I'm almost positive.
In a place like
his body was under at the very back of the diner.
After the killer murdered Byaku, they probably moved the body
there. There we go.
No, that's wrong.
That is wrong, Kazuichi. Always wrong.
I know, he sure speaks a lot and he's often wrong.
He probably shouldn't.
No, I don't think the killer moved the body. Huh? Why? Try to remember what the body looked like when we found it under the table.
Yeah, it was a pretty big mess.
Though there was a lot of blood everywhere, there was no sign the killer actually dragged the body through it.
Yep, that's what I noticed.
So that's why you think it's impossible that the killer moved the body. I see. I get your point.
Aww. And here I thought I had a genius idea.
Aww.
Yeah, nice try.
Too bad you're so stupid and boring and unpopular. Your life is meaningless.
That might be going a little too far.
I like
just
him.
A little bit.
Praise, you know.
But if the killer didn't move the body, why was it under the table?
Because they were killed there. Just a wild theory. Just a wild, wild speculation.
You think he was killed under the table?
Why not?
So Byakuya snuck under the table for reasons unknown, and that's when he was killed.
Well, not necessarily for reasons unknown. I think we kind of know those already.
Then, shortly thereafter, we found his body under the table.
Mm-hmm.
That does make sense, but why did he go under the table?
Obviously, he was hiding so he could surprise us.
What?
Dude was always a big jokester.
Did you pay any attention to him at all? That was not his personality.
The hell he was? You seriously couldn't tell what kind of person he was?
Maybe he panicked during the blackout and dove under the table.
I don't think so.
It's a blackout, not an earthquake. Just because the power went out doesn't mean he'd dive under the table.
The reason why is probably connected to what Byakuya was doing during the party, don't you think?
Yes, I think. The reason Byakuya dove under the table, if it's connected to what Byakuya was doing during the party, then it's probably, the knife? Would that be it?
I guess. Isn't that why he went under?
Yeah, I'm just seeing if there's anything else that would be a possibility. Yeah, I think it's the knife.
I agree.
I can prove it with this.
Oh, he can prove it. Oh, his finger looked creepy.
Probably has something to do with the knife we found under.
Really?
The
I didn't see it.
It was moving and it scared me.
I'll have to pay attention next time.
Knife? Oh, you mean that thing that obviously screams, "I am the murder weapon!"
It may scream that, but it isn't.
It might be a red herring.
Byakuya probably noticed the knife was hidden there. So in order to get it,
how'd he notice that? Oh, with the goggles.
Yeah, we're gonna go over this slowly.
I know.
To the presence of dangerous items, so I cannot deny that possibility.
Of course, Gundam, you have to make it sound so epic.
But how did he
everything he says is epic. Where are the hams?
I'm sure they'll come out eventually as this goes on.
If he knew before,
I think they should each get a vote.
Would have done something about it before the blackout, right? Then, instead of knowing about it beforehand, maybe he saw it right at that moment.
Yeah, most likely.
Like, for example, he might have seen someone trying to take the knife out from under the table.
That is quite possible, Shafty.
No, that's not possible.
What?
Really?
What? You seem rather confident about that.
Of course.
But you weren't even in the room.
And we have proof to contradict your proof.
This is almost like a real trial.
Almost? Come on. We're doing pretty good. During the previous statement, there was only one weak spot. From this point on, there'll be various weak spots standing your way.
Oh.
Alright, so. Yeah, we're pretty much going over like the first stuff in the first shot of the last game. Like, we're getting introduced to the concept of multiple things that we have to spot out, so. This is pretty familiar. Full weak spots. Yeah, so that won't work. And a lower trust and influence gauge. Alright, so this is all pretty obvious.
Be extra careful.
I will try to be. I mean, I can't guarantee we'll do it perfectly, and yeah, it's right bumper to do the concentrate. So I'll have to use that every now and then. Does it make things so much easier? Yeah, okay. Thank you. Alright, and I'll watch it all as usual, just to make sure we have the right thing. Wow, these all the options? We have a lot, actually.
It's probably gonna be night vision goggles.
I would assume so, yeah.
I'm sure Byakuya ducked under the table during the blackout.
Okay.
That sounds correct.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So if far, so good.
The case, during the blackout, Mr. Ham-Ham...
Still calling that.
...seen the killer take the knife. But it was super pitch black.
Yeah, but he had night vision goggles.
It was so dark I couldn't see my food.
You really have a one-track mind.
See in the dark either.
That's not
yes,
true.
Yes, he could.
Yeah, we'll do that after this. Does it show the amount of statements in this one? Like in the last game it showed on the side? I didn't see it. Okay.
Oh, it says start to finish.
Oh yeah, there's a little thing.
But it doesn't have like, it doesn't really show you how many.
I do kind of like the original thing better.
Yeah, me too.
The way it showed it. This is more clear how many we had. Okay.
I noticed something just now before.
What was it?
Like right on this line. I think she is a familiar voice.
No, that's wrong.
Who? Akane?
Yeah, I think she's Faye Valentine.
Oh, really?
I think so.
Yakuya was interesting.
The only one who was able to see in the dark.
Why do you say that?
Well, did you see it was right next to him? Well, then again, she wasn't really investigating. I guess she went
under the table. He could have seen what was happening.
So, are you saying Byakuya was the one who used those night vision goggles?
Well, they were right next to him.
Yeah, that seems to be the case.
Your reasoning is out of focus.
What?
What?
Where the hell did she come from?
I don't know.
No, that's obviously wrong. It should be the other way around.
What?
What? The other way around? Why?
Other way around?
Seriously? The killer used those night vision goggles, not Byakuya.
No, they were in Byakuya's case. And he had the
come
key to it.
Come on now, girl.
Yes,
yes,
I was a little bit surprised by a sudden argument that came out of nowhere. Just between you and me, I was also surprised. I'll get to know that narrator.
And she's like screaming, she's right next to us.
Oh, they're just kidding, I'm sorry. Well, of course, you're the guys that made the game. Stop messing with me. Now then, when this kind of argument surfaces, you'll go into a one-on-one debate called Rebuttal Showdown.
Oh.
Wait, is this new? Or is this supposed to be that thing from the other game?
Not sure.
The rhythm thing. In this mode, you have to counter the other person's claim, draw out their weak spots, and argue against them. Please counter the other person's argument with the left stick. Oh, so this is different. Okay. But what do I do with the left stick?
I don't know.
Based on the shape of their remarks, it's important to know whether they're cut vertically, sideways, or...
It's the blade!
Oh, no. There is something with the blade. I thought there was, because of the, the skills hinted towards that. Vertically, sideways, or diagonally. I'm gonna mess this up. I just know it already. And based on that, you can skew the debate's mood to your advantage. On the other hand, if you ignore the other person's remarks, it will skew towards their advantage. In the bottom right-hand corner of your screen, a number that shows the sharpness of your counter is displayed. This is a lot to remember.
Mm-hmm.
This is the number of times you can cut remarks during one round of the debate.
Oh god.
Oh, what? Really? You'll lose counts of sharpness even if you miss, so please be very careful. When the mood skews to your advantage for a certain length of time, the other party's argument changes. This means the conversation will develop.
Okay.
If that happens, they'll end up divulging some weak spots. However, you cannot normally cut remarks that contain weak spots. Instead, it will skew the mood towards the other party's advantage. Plus, it's going to be very big.
What?
Why are you being vague about this game?
I'm so confused.
What does it mean by very... What is this? The non-unknown button? Just like a regular debate, please review any weak spots with the... I guess that's the Y button again?
I don't know.
I'm assuming. Of course, if you don't have the correct truth blade, you will not be able to cut an opponent's remark.
Oh no.
Huh? What's a truth blade? I am terribly sorry. It appears there's been a delay in contacting you. What? I'll make sure the person in charge of contacting you takes a very long vacation. Whoa. What is going on here? This game's getting very mysterious.
Uh-oh.
In this mode, truth bullets will now be called truth blades. Okay. It took them too long to change the name in this game. That's about it. There won't be any other changes to your handbook menu. Only the name was changed, but don't you think a change in feeling is important? Alright, so we can review the controls if you want to. Jeez. Alright, maybe I'll review them just in case. If I can quickly get a chance. Alright, hold on a second. I want to review the...
If you just use common sense. The killer obviously...
Wait, what am I doing?
You're supposed to be using... You're dying.
I can't advance forward from just listening. I should let Mihiro say what she wants to say and then find a point where I can argue against. Yeah, I'm trying to see what I'm supposed to do. There's something like going along the bottom of the screen, but it's very... I don't know. I didn't really notice it at first. So which way am I going? Does it mean I'm going left or right? I guess to the left because she's to the left?
I guess.
Because I don't see any clues as to do it vertically or diagonally or whatever.
No.
If you just use common... The killer obviously used those night vision goggles. That's gotta be it.
I can't back down.
Oh. Duel. Oh, what the hell? At the mesh A. Okay.
Success.
I'm not exactly sure when I'm supposed to be using the, whatever.
They use night vision goggles. Then they could have killed Byakuya even in the dark.
I guess it went on my side?
I mean, reality, I don't know.
That's what happened. So those goggles were...
Or is it when it's under the knife itself? Or whatever?
I have no idea. Oh, look. Oh.
I found a hole in your argument. I did?
Yeah, there was an orange text.
Well, I'm too busy trying to pay attention to the rhythm of it or whatever, and I still can't figure that out.
So we have to find the case for the goggles to refute the claim.
All right, at the...
So, they use night vision goggles.
There's a case.
And they could have killed Byakuya even in the dark. I mean, in reality, that's what happened. So those goggles were planned in advance.
The hell?
The killer brought them to the crime scene.
Oh.
Allow me to cut through those words.
Okay. Did that work?
I guess.
I don't think that's how we're supposed to do it, though.
No.
I don't know how to do that. When am I supposed to be doing the rhythm?
I have no idea.
Is it what's in the center of the screen, or... I wasn't sure at all.
I guess we'll get comments explaining.
I'm sure someone will point it out at some point. Okay, yeah. Yeah, Byakuya obviously used them. They were in his case.
Inside the Duralumin case Byakuya had with him during the party, we found a smaller case for storing the night vision goggles.
Which means we can assume that the night vision goggles were kept inside that Duralumin case as well.
Yeah, it's a lot to learn at once. You have to, like, know the rhythm of what you're supposed to do. And for that one, I think I only had to cut sideways, although maybe I was wrong about that, because that's all I was doing and some of them didn't connect. I don't know. It'll probably become much clearer to me when I do it in editing. I'll be like, oh, that's what I was supposed to do.
Uses such clever language.
Yeah, good for you, Ibuki.
Plus, Byakuya was the only one who could have taken the night vision goggles out of the case, since he was carrying it around before the blackout in the first place.
I see. When you put it like that, it makes sense.
Yeah, how dare you cut me with your remarks, Mihiro?
Then, was that
for no reason to?
Inside the case too?
No.
If there were night vision goggles inside, it wouldn't be weird for a knife to be in there too.
No, it's because he confiscated all the weapons and put them in the other case.
It would be weird.
Yeah, thank you, Chucky. She's been paying attention this game.
I am weird, aren't I? Times like this, I'd rather be fantasizing about tonight's main dish.
I'm pretty sure she wasn't talking about that.
You totally mean that in a perverted way.
I wouldn't be surprised. The knife was brought in the Duralumin case. Along with the night vision goggles too?
No.
No, that's not possible. The knife was hidden in the dining hall before the party even started. I should be able to prove it.
Tonight's main dish.
Not sure what I'm supposed to pick exactly.
Duct tape.
Oh, the duct tape, obviously. Yeah, because it's duct taped on there.
You were supposed to choose tonight's main dish.
There was duct tape left under the table where the body was found.
Yeah, I was thinking it was going to have something to do with the other case where he had the weapons stored, but there's also the fact that it was taped to the table.
They probably hit the knife by duct taping it to the underside of the table.
Oh, so that's why we found duct tape there.
Yep.
Though Byakuya was thorough, even he couldn't have noticed a weapon taped to the underside of the table.
Yeah, I guess he can't really bend over too much because it'll be too much trouble to get back up.
This may be off topic. But why was Byakuya acting so paranoid?
Oh, we do have evidence of that as well, actually.
Not only did he bring a self-defense kit, but he had night vision goggles inside the case too.
That's true. He went above and beyond being a little cautious.
No, it is interesting, though. I think if he was worried about a power outage, he would have checked everything in regards to the power beforehand.
Mm.
But whatever. Like I said, a lot on his hands.
Now that you mention it, that applies to the dangerous items he confiscated as well. It's one thing to be a little cautious, but performing a body check is a bit much.
Well, I mean, I guess.
He probably knew someone was planning to commit a murder.
Nikito, you were there.
Yeah, come on, stop playing coy.
Are you saying he predicted the murder?
Whoa.
Could it be? Was he also in possession of the all-seeing eye?
I'm sure that's what it was, Gundam. He can communicate with the occult.
You think so too, right, Hajime?
What, you mean with what you said or what Gundam just said? That's right. Byakuya probably knew there was the possibility that a murder would occur. It was the... where is it? Where's the note? Murder threat.
I can prove it with this.
Creepy finger.
Everyone, can you please take a look at this?
Yeah, be careful. The first kill will happen tonight. Someone will definitely kill someone.
Hey, the hell is this?
It's a threat.
Hajime and I found this in Byakuya's cottage.
Yeah.
It looks like a threatening letter someone sent to him.
So, who's the someone?
Well, that's the question, isn't it?
Nobody besides Monokuma would write such a dumb, threatening letter like that.
I wouldn't be so sure about that.
Wasn't me!
Exactly.
Are you sure?
The only lies I tell are friendly lies!
That's not true at all.
Those are still lies! Doesn't matter who wrote it yet. So, Byakuya became paranoid because of this threatening letter?
Well, it is pretty nerve-wracking when someone says they're gonna murder someone for sure.
He probably decided to throw a party because of the letter. What do you mean? By gathering everyone in one place, he tried to create a situation where everyone could keep tabs on each other.
And unfortunately, that's exactly what created the situation that led to the murder.
Mm-hmm.
In doing so, he tried to put the writer of the letter in a situation where they couldn't act.
But the letter might have been just a little prank.
A little prank? Really, that's some prank.
As long as he was determined not to let any of us die, he couldn't take that risk. His strong sense of responsibility made him believe the letter was legitimate.
Ugh. He should have told us he received a threatening letter.
Yeah, but that would create a panic.
If he had, we would have panicked.
Exactly.
Byakuya probably knew that too.
So, he tried to do something about it without telling anyone?
Hmm. I guess. I'm not sure if it was the best method, though, if I'm being honest.
I see. A strong sense of responsibility as our leader was his undoing.
Yeah, seems to.
Screw that noise! Who the hell wrote that letter?
Well, obviously, the killer.
Hmm. Well, not necessarily.
Very true.
There are two people acting. The killer. Yes, the killer. Is it really one of us?
Yes.
Who is it? Among us? Who's the one who killed Byakuya?
Enough already! Show yourself, you coward!
I'm sure that's gonna work.
If they were willing to come forward, they never would have committed a murder in the first place.
But I still can't believe it. Someone in this room killed Byakuya? There's no way I can believe that yet. But we were believing that.
Pardon me. Can I say something, please?
Sure.
What is it, Miss Sonia?
Kazuichi, really.
I regret that I must return to this topic, but I just realized something concerning the night vision goggles. If Byakuya was indeed wearing those goggles, how did the killer manage to navigate in the dark?
That's a good question, actually.
You're right. They wouldn't have been able to see anything without the night vision goggles. But if the murderer had the goggles when they took the knife, then how did Byakuya see them?
Even if the knife bore some sort of mark, it would have been difficult to see it in that darkness.
Well, it was more than just a mark. It was glow-in-the-dark paint.
It was glow-in-the-dark paint. Where was it?
It was that glowing paint.
It was Byakuya Togami?
Byakuya himself was the clue.
What if the glowing paint was the mark? With that, you'd be able to get the knife even in the dark. In actuality, the knife we found under the table
had paint on it.
And the duct tape stuck to the underside of the table were both marked with glowing paint, right?
Right.
Correct.
Does that mean the killer painted them in advance?
They sure did.
But painting them with glowing paint? It's as if they knew the blackout was going to happen.
Almost as if, huh? Isn't that funny?
They had to have already known. That's why they used the glowing paint as a mark.
Yeah, I like this. Jackie actually is pretty smart.
Mm-hmm.
I knew I liked her.
Which means whoever set up the blackout is the killer.
That seals it. The killer is whoever was in the office with the circuit breaker.
No. So far I have to say, it seems like we don't have anyone that's as smart as Kyoko was.
No.
Even if they are pretty good, some of them.
Which means it was you, Peko Pekoyama.
Why? Didn't we already determine that she couldn't have reached it in the first place?
Mm-hmm.
Peko killed poor Byakuya?
Oh,
was
no.
This island not big enough for two glasses wearers?
Don't jump to conclusions like that.
I'm not the killer. Oh, I guess she's not.
Kane. So easily convinced.
But with Peko's height, I don't think she'd be able to reach the circuit breaker in the office.
I don't care about a technicality like that.
Really?
Peko's the one who tripped the breaker and caused the blackout.
Here we go again. By tripping the breaker directly from the office, Peko was the one who caused the blackout? Is that really what happened?
No.
Oh, blue-colored weak spots will start appearing.
What does
so that's
blue?
The noise, right? The static? Or is it something different? If you call the weak spots you've seen up until now argy spots, what? The blue-colored weak spots will be called agree spots. No, this is different then. Okay. When shooting agree spots with truth bullets, you need to flip your way of thinking. Instead of arguing that the other person's testimony contains lies or mistakes, please fire the truth bullets that proves the other person's testimony is correct.
Oh, goodness.
Wow, okay. They are introducing some new concepts already. When your truth bullets merge with their weakness, they'll become a logically sound agreement. Huh. Isn't it a little hot in here? Whoa, what are you talking about, narrator? From now, you must infer whether it's best to argue or agree based on what's being debated. That's gonna make things a bit more difficult.
But I thought it's blue now. So isn't that easier?
No. Yeah, but so to determine whether you want to argue something or agree with something.
I guess.
So that's a lot to keep in mind. Maybe not a lot, but it's just something new anyway. We have different accounts.
Since Peko was in the office, she could have caused the blackout at any time.
Nekomaru knew she was in the bathroom.
Huh? Why is it impossible?
Because I was not in the office. Not even before the blackout.
Right.
Yeah.
Nekomaru knew that.
What happened to your guard duty?
Right? Didn't he?
He should have known that. So is that it?
You weren't in the office?
I guess so.
Well, I mean, I know which one I want to agree with. I mean, you might be right. I just want to refer to the rest of these things, just to see. It's not weird to doubt her, but I feel like I spoke to someone during the investigation who totally backs up her testimony. Let's see. So the testimonies, we'll just review each one that appeared. That's useless. Was it Chiaki's one of them?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's useless too. Kazuichi's was his one because
no,
it's pointless.
No, it wasn't.
Nekomaru, okay. It could refer to that, although I don't think he knew for sure it was her.
No, but we can use it to
Back up the weaknesses
up her,
or whatever they said?
Yes.
Yeah, I guess so.
That exactly.
That's impossible. Huh? Why is it impossible?
Because I was not in the office.
Yeah, she was right.
Not even before the book.
Did that work?
Consent.
Consent. I guess the consent worked. Okay. Break.
No, I think Peko is telling the truth.
Alright, I kind of like that. It is interesting and unique.
Mm-hmm. Don't tell me you're crushing on Peko.
Kazuichi.
It's nothing like that at all. Nekomaru's account is actually Peko's alibi.
Even if he didn't actually know it. I've been trying to use it many times, but the door just won't open at all.
It's true. Someone was occupying the bathroom for a long time shortly after the party started.
And the only person it could have been
was finally freed up after Byakuya's body was discovered.
Then the person who was in the bathroom that whole time was actually...
Yeah, it's true. She was the only one that really left the room at that point.
Everyone else besides Peko was in the dining hall after the party started, right?
Yeah.
I see. So there's no way anybody else could have locked themselves in the bathroom except Peko.
I guess that would be true.
Well, yeah, it's no time to be embarrassed now.
You locked yourself in the commode? You should have said so
Kazuichi.
Earlier.
Do you have no respect?
There's no
way she'd actually say that. Gosh, you are so insensitive.
She locked herself in the bathroom for that long? There's no doubt. It's shit.
I mean, wow. It might literally be that, but I don't think we need to address that actual issue.
Oh, there's no way she'd admit it. There's no way she'd admit she was taking a shit.
They'll just call him Captain Sensitivity from now on.
Hey, were you guys taught any basic manners, or were you raised in a locker room?
Well, I mean, it is Nekomaru. He probably was, to be fair.
I'm sorry.
It's fine. How about we stop talking about this and move on?
Kazuchi's face. He's horrified.
Don't worry. The smell wasn't that strong.
Nekomaru.
Right after you, so you can trust me.
There's more important matters to discuss at this point.
I said it's fine.
But still, you were in the bathroom for a really long time.
This is a good point. This is something that's kind of worrying about, being that we know who the cook was and his weird way with girls.
As
soon as I stepped into the office, I felt this sudden rush of pain in my stomach.
But Nekomaru got it too, I think.
That's true.
Because of that, I was unable to leave the bathroom. Including when the blackout occurred.
Alright.
Hey, how did it feel to do your business in the dark? Excited?
Okay. Maybe he did do it after all. He seems way too excited about this.
Seriously, stop it. But still, your stomach pain. Was that really just a coincidence?
I know, it's interesting, isn't it?
Hey, what's the deal? Don't butt into other people's business, especially if you didn't do any investigating.
He does raise a point.
I'm only butting in because you fucking idiots are out of your element.
Stop this childish nonsense. Just what do you mean by coincidence?
What I mean is it possible someone slipped her some laxatives?
Laxatives?
If so, the killer could have tripped the breaker as soon as that girl left the office, don't you think?
Well, I don't think anyone tripped the breaker. We already have evidence to that.
I see. That might have happened.
It might not have.
The question is whether Peiko's stomach ache was a coincidence, or if someone intentionally caused it. Depending on the answer, the outcome of this trial could change drastically.
Oh, goodness.
Alright, let's see.
Party dishes? What?
Did you eat anything weird?
I don't remember eating anything weird.
I'm not sure exactly.
You mention it. You brought food to the office, right?
Yes.
Yeah, she did bring some food with her to eat.
From the dining hall.
There might have been some laxatives in it, don't you think?
Taro cooked the food. How suspicious!
I wouldn't do anything like that.
Sure he wouldn't.
Laxatives would ruin the taste.
Whether Peiko's stomach ache was a coincidence, or if someone intentionally caused it. It might have just been a coincidence, because I don't think it has to do with someone resetting the break or whatever.
But I guess he wouldn't. No, but she wouldn't be able to reach it. Never mind. Yeah, I guess it must be.
But what will it be?
What does it say for whatever the plates of food? Party dishes.
Akane and Peiko. And Akane didn't get sick.
Yeah, okay.
So it might be that?
Okay, yeah.
I guess so. Unless she didn't tell us something.
I don't remember eating anything weird. Now that you mention it,
I didn't see where the other prompt was for this. I'll have to just watch again.
To the office, right? Just a little bit from the dining hall.
There might have been some laxatives in it, don't you think?
That one?
Oh, I guess I'll try.
No, that's wrong.
I think it worked.
I think so. I wasn't too sure about that one, to be honest.
Well, the other one was like it would ruin the taste.
Yeah, I didn't think it would.
Were slipped into the food in the dining hall. Because Peiko wasn't the only one who ate that food. Akane ate some of it too.
Yeah, and she didn't seem to be sick.
If the food had laxatives in it, I'm pretty sure Akane would have had stomach issues as well.
And the other person was Byakyo, who ate those
the
things on the skewers. But, you know, we can't really tell for sure not what he would have had, because he kind of bit it before. Anything could happen.
Like I said, the dishes are innocent. Don't go making weird accusations.
Well, the dishes are innocent, at least.
I apologize for causing a scene. Fuyuhiko should apologize, not you. He's the one who made the laxative accusation.
What the fuck did you say, bitch?
Oh.
There's this bickering.
Let's just dismiss Peko's stomach ache as a coincidence and go back to discussing the blackout.
Very good.
Yeah,
nice suggestion.
We already know that, you trashy stink. You don't have to tell us.
Whoa.
Why do you hate her so much? I don't understand what she has against her. She's always going after her in particular, and then like Kazuichi as a guy.
I guess because they're easy targets.
I guess so.
They're not going to put up a fight.
As long as the murder happened during the blackout, then the blackout itself is what is actually important. We need to make it clear how the blackout occurred. Yes, it's about time we did that.
Timer.
We have a couple of things
AC
for this.
AC timer.
There's an AC timer. The iron's in the storage closet. And I think that's all it's using power.
The breaker, and how did they do it? If you can't answer that, I'm gonna bop you on the head. Did they
must be the irons.
I guess so. No, they didn't throw a stone.
Maybe they used a remote control?
Kind of.
They probably messed with the breaker.
Not exactly.
It does not have to be the breaker.
That's true.
They may have tampered with the power supply and transmitters.
Maybe they caused a power surge?
Is that what
that
is? That
would be considered?
I bet it's really Monokuma's fault.
That's it.
Yeah, of course.
I'm not a treasure skank.
Oh my god.
So which one would that go for? Is it the one about surge? A power surge?
I guess.
Because he basically overloaded it. And, I guess power surge.
I guess that's.
If that's the word for it.
Who tripped the breaker and how did they do it?
I mean, power surge usually something happens with lightning or whatever. But I guess I could be this too.
Did they throw a stone and hit it?
Maybe they used a remote.
They probably messed with the breaker.
It does not have to be the breaker. They may have tampered with the power supply entrance.
Or maybe they caused a power
Consent. I give you my consent.
I don't like consent.
It's so odd. The I'm not sure if that's the right
wording.
Word for it. It's more like, I don't know. Just agree.
Yeah.
Of course, that's not a coincidence. Someone caused it intentionally. Which is why those three irons were arranged to cause the blackout.
Yeah. Kind of weird how they were in the closet, huh?
We found them right after the blackout. The irons were still on.
Almost like someone was trying to intentionally overload it.
So by leaving those irons on in the storage room, they deliberately caused a power surge.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It seems that's how the killer caused the blackout.
Stupid fool!
What?
What
the hell?
Happened?
Why are you getting upset, Nekomaru?
Oh no.
Hold on a second. Let me speak too.
Well, we have to fight
him. You're free
him.
To speak, but what about that you disagree with?
What the heck?
We have to fight him with a blade.
You say the irons in the storage room were used to trigger the blackout?
Partly.
Yeah? They helped.
That's inexcusable!
Why?
It is inexcusable, but how does that refute what I say? Oh boy, not this again. I'm gonna mess this up this time, I bet. AC timer? What? Irons in storage room?
If the irons in the storage
Look, vertical.
I can't even read. Oh.
Then for the killer to turn
vertical,
the
vertical.
On, you're saying they went all the way to the storage room?
Where am I doing it? I don't
Oh, there's a little thing on the bottom. Look. A little yellow guy. When that lines up with them, you have
when
to
when it lines
it.
Up with what? I know
the
there's
text?
A thing going along the bottom. Where it lines up with the text?
Probably.
That makes sense. Damn it, why didn't I figure that out sooner?
I didn't know there was a little thing on the bottom until just
I just
then.
Need to respond. Right, let's see.
Caused the and for the killer to turn the irons on. You're saying they went all the way to the storage room? And that means everyone who is in the
My reaction's too slow, damn it.
The blackout occurred, can't be a suspect.
Okay. I don't know if I'm just really bad at this. Do you want to give it a shot?
No. I'm terrible
okay,
at rhythm
so.
Games.
Not a suspect sounding like that. It's dangerous. I should address that first.
The irons in the storage room caused the blackout. Then for the killer to turn the irons on. You're saying they went all the way to the storage room? And that means everyone who is in the dining hall.
Am I really just missing it by that little
or
bit?
Or do you
amount?
Think you are supposed to hit when it's. I think it's the text.
Huh. This is becoming a real pain in the ass right now.
I know.
The irons in the storage room caused the blackout. Then for the killer to turn the irons on.
Or is it only when something's in the center?
They went all the way to the
I don't know.
Room. And that means everyone who is in the dining
No, that didn't work.
Blackout occurred, can't be a suspect.
The hell?
maybe it is supposed to be wherever the screen is.
I am honestly confused on how you're supposed to be doing this.
Like where the split is?
Is there anything else about this? The direction you press, yeah, we know that.
Oh, you can concentrate.
All right, let's see how else if I concentrate during this, if that helps out. I don't know if it'd help out during this one. I guess it does. Oh, I ran out of the thing. Oh, I missed.
You're saying they went all the way to the storage room?
Damn it.
And that means everyone who was in the dining hall.
Ugh. Doesn't do any good. It kind of helped a little bit, but I'm really bad at this timing on this one.
Oh, no.
So, yeah. We're just going to do this 15 times, I guess. I told you guys I was terrible at rhythm games. That time it worked.
You're saying they went all the way to the storage room? And that means
wait,
who is in the
hold on.
What?
What? Oh, I pressed the wrong button for some reason. I can do it sideways, and that works.
Oh. I thought I had to do it vertically. Maybe it's too difficult to do it vertically, so you have to do it sideways?
Alright,
and maybe before we should have been doing it vertically instead of sideways?
I guess. I don't know why it worked when I did it vertically then that one time. Let's see.
Well, I mean,
let me try it again this way.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think you can do it anyway,
so
but
it's based on what side of the screen it's on, I guess.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, I think. Alright, well, this is so much easier now I finally know how it works.
I'm so confused.
What am I doing now? Okay. No, I finally got it.
If the irons caused, then the killer had to go to the storage room before that and turn on the irons.
Oh no, I have to do the, I have to do the AC one for
that.
Yeah,
you missed
okay.
it.
Okay, yeah, I just realized.
If the irons in the storage room caused the blackout.
Hold on, oh shit.
That one.
Turn the irons on. You're saying they went all the way to the storage room? And that means everyone who, when the blackout occurred...
Alright, this is... It's just you don't know what you... Oh, with the mash, okay. Oh, he's strong. Okay, you did the...
No, just because people were in the dining hall... Doesn't mean they're not a suspect.
Yeah, exactly.
But the people in the dining hall weren't able to keep the up, and the killer had to go to the storage room and turn on the iron. Now do you intend to take back what you said?
No, I don't.
But the people in the dining hall weren't able to keep the irons caught.
There, use it.
Oh, it's in that one. Okay, I see.
Allow me to cut through those words.
There we go, finally.
There's one reason the blackout occurred, but they weren't the direct trigger. The direct trigger was when the air conditioners in the dining hall and office clicked on.
Yeah, this is another one of those games where I feel like you have to like experience it for the first time before you really get mm-hmm. what you're supposed to be doing. You just kind of like fumble around a bit, like testing out different things.
The air conditioners!
Like, I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I always feel like the instructions they kind of give for these minigames aren't really as clear as they should be.
Mm-hmm.
The timers for both air conditioners were set to 11:30 p.m.
11:30 p.m. Mr. Ham-Ham's died around that time, too!
I see. When the timers activated the air conditioners, the breaker was tripped and caused a blackout. I see! I understand! Indubitably!
Indubitably, really?
Indubitably?
Yeah.
They probably checked the old building's energy usage in advance, and used the irons to nearly max it out.
Hmm.
So once they set the air conditioner's timers, they just had to wait until they started up on their own.
So yeah, is that what you did, Nagito?
So, even if Pekka was in the office, it still would have been possible to cause a blackout, indubitably.
Indubitably? Miss Sonia, not you too.
What? Why don't you mean not you too? What's wrong with the word?
Regarding the energy usage, they probably asked Monokuma about it.
Maybe? And who's the one person that knows how to call Monokuma?
Hmm.
Interesting.
Dun, dun, dun.
Did they ask you, Monokuma?
Right? Such a hateful bear. You deserve to die a thousand deaths.
A thousand, you say? If I died that many times, I might really stay dead, you know?
Really?
Shut up!
That'd be a shame.
You guys just stay quiet!
Couldn't have prevented the blackout even if I was in the office.
I kind of want to know the answer to that, though.
So,
did someone ask Monokuma? Because that would be a pretty telling clue, I think.
If I was in the office, I could have reset the breaker in time. And maybe the murder wouldn't have occurred.
No,
oh no, she's going to blame herself now.
The breaker in the office was built into a high area of the wall that's impossible to reach. Resetting the breaker in that darkness would have been impossible.
no matter what. Sounds like you don't need to blame yourself.
Even so, the killer is so sly. I'm starting to worry we may never actually find them.
It's all right. You don't have to worry.
What does that mean?
Because they're just a petty killer, right? They can't defeat symbols of hope like you guys.
What? Huh? Who are you talking about?
There's no way everybody will lose now. This little incident will just be a stepping stone for you all.
What?
Nagito, you're monologuing. That's usually not a good sign.
In the end, hope always wins. That's what I believe.
Nagito? What happened to you?
Nagito, or Nagato, as I should probably say is the correct pronunciation. You're starting to monologue like a James Bond villain or something like that.
Huh? What do you mean?
Well,
do you not hear yourself?
You have been saying this whole time that there's no way a killer could be among us.
Oh, is that so? Well, let's just put that minor detail aside for now and talk about the incident.
Minor little detail.
For now, we found out how the blackout
That music's all innocent again.
The question is, who
As if that weirdness
it,
didn't
right?
just happen.
Anybody could have hid and set the timers for the air conditioners.
Especially the person who was cleaning it.
Room could have been done
yeah.
before Byakuya set foot in the old building.
And who had access to there and wouldn't let us go in when we tried to?
What a shame. Any one of us is capable of that.
Not true
Incorrect.
At all.
Correct.
Not
what
true at
you
all.
Implying?
He's just saying, after all this time, we still haven't made any progress.
Not we have made progress. Don't believe him. He's full of it.
Even though we have been arguing for so long?
Unfortunately, it's the truth.
No, it's bullshit. You're just trying to make people think that.
Despite the fact that we've discussed this at length, there's not even one clue that leads to the killer.
Oh, he is so full of it.
But that might be because there's no way any of us could be a killer.
Is anyone else noticing how full of shit he is right now?
No one.
You're changing your story again?
Anyway, I have an idea about what we all should do at this point. Has anyone thought about our situation like this?
Like what?
Instead of surviving by doubting others, isn't it better to get killed for believing in others?
He's completely insane.
Doesn't that mean? Are you saying we should all just give up and die?
Nagito, there's definitely something wrong.
Wow,
with
the game's just playing itself now. Alright, now it's stopped. Okay.
You guys only think there's something wrong with me because there's something wrong with you.
What?
What does that mean?
Suspecting each other like this. There's no way that's healthy behavior. Let's stop this already. We don't have to find out who the killer is.
What?
The only person that works to the benefit of is the killer.
I can't stand this anymore. I don't want to do this to my friends.
Shut up.
I don't want to do this either.
Well, of course you don't.
Yeah, I think these two have pretty much implicated themselves.
Me too! Please!
Oh great, now everyone's having an emotional breakdown.
I want to go home and eat candy!
What? Yoko, what the hell?
Stop it. If everyone acts like this, I'm gonna...
Everyone calm down.
That's right, everyone just needs to settle down right now.
We're all friends.
Stop being so dramatic.
There's no way one friend would murder another.
Well, not necessarily. We've only known each other for a few days. And we don't know how everyone acts around here.
Then why did Byakuya die?
Who cares? Let's just give up already.
This is a great strategy, by the way, Nagito.
There are no clues that lead to the killer anyway. Not a single one.
That's wrong.
Oh, Chiaki! The combo breaker. She's putting an end to this bullshit.
I think.
Stay strong, Chiaki.
Just like frozen in place.
Did you say something?
Oh.
Yeah, you're saying to shut the fuck up.
Guys, we've already found a clue that might point to who the killer is.
Yay.
Damn, I like Chiaki. She's coming out strong in this episode.
You know who the killer is?
I don't know, but we do have a clue about a suspicious person.
Yeah, someone's acting very suspicious right now, by the way. And the awesome hoodie's made a comeback. Nice to see.
I see. Then care to tell me, what's this clue you're talking about?
First of all, let's try thinking about how the killer was able to obtain the knife during the blackout.
Didn't we already cover that? They used glowing paint as a mark.
No, not that. I mean before that.
Ooh. Before? Is she asking how the killer got close to that table? Even if they had to obtain the knife by relying on the glow from the paint in order to do that, they needed to get close to that table while it was still dark.
The killer looked like a bathroom
Let's try
sign.
Examining the situation. My hero's diagram might be useful here.
It will be, yes.
I'm glad this has come into play.
The diagram of where everyone was standing before the blackout, right? Here it is.
Thank you, Mihira. Yes, that's very telling, I think. Just as I thought, this diagram is the clue. Who the killer is, and how they're able to move to the table in the dark. That's clearly shown in this diagram. First, we need to discuss how the killer was able to move to that table in the dark. Alright, let's do it. The killer probably used something to help them move in the dark. Ooh, what am I picking? Should I pick the lamp itself or the cord?
Can you pick the cord?
Which one do you think I should pick?
The cord.
Okay, let's see.
Here!
The finger.
The killer must have used the desk lamp to move to that table in the dark.
The desk lamp? I hope you don't mean they turned on a light or something.
That's not what I mean at all.
There was a blackout. There's no way the killer could have used the desk lamp.
Not in the way you're thinking. Of course, there's no way they used the desk lamp's light. The killer actually used the power cord.
The weight.
The weight.
I don't even know how they would use the weight.
They could just sense the gravity.
They used its power cord.
Power cord?
Yep, the power cord.
They could have felt their way to that table using the power cord, right? By doing that, the killer was able to move to the table, then use the glowing paint to find the knife.
And there's only one person here who could have done that.
The only person here who could have possibly done it. Well, there's only one person who could have done that anyway. The person who's standing right next to it. Mr. Cheerful, who's looking so much different from every other student.
Yeah, really.
You're the only one! Nagito, it was you, wasn't it?
Me?
Well, of course, you.
Judging from everyone's positions before the blackout, the only person near the power cord was you.
Which means, the only one who could have felt their way to the table using the power cord was Nagito!
That's just a coincidence.
Oh, of course, yeah, now it's a coincidence.
But still, you had a chance, right? A chance to hide the knife under the table?
Yes, he did. It was, when he was cleaning up.
Mm-hmm.
That was his chance.
I see.
Nagito, weren't you cleaning the dining hall all morning?
And he pretty much volunteered himself for it, or stage events to make him be the one.
If so, you would have had a chance to hide the knife.
That's...
If you factor in the power cord and the time you spent cleaning, you're the only one who could have done it.
Seriously, that's all just a coincidence.
Yeah, ever since the beginning of the chapter, he's been putting this plan into motion. You can kind of see like the little things he did.
Yeah, definitely.
If it's one coincidence, it'd be fine. But when it's one right after another, I wonder, is something like that even possible?
Yeah, all those coincidences become pretty damning when they add up like that.
Did you give yourself cleaning duty on purpose?
Oh, he almost certainly did.
Under the table?
Mm-hmm.
Now that you mention it, Nagito did prepare the drawing to pick who cleaned the dining hall.
And suspiciously said something like, oh, just in case something like this happened, yeah. I prepared for this. Yeah, exactly. To be honest, I already prepared a drawing because I assumed something like this would happen. How convenient. So go to the trouble of preparing this, just what did you think would happen? Whoever draws the chopstick with the red mark on it will be in charge of cleaning, okay? Does that sound fair?
Sure.
You rigged the drawing, didn't you? That's how you got picked to clean the dining hall, isn't it?
Dirty scoundrel, you.
I don't know if you're the killer or not, but regardless, it proves that you're suspicious, right?
I have to agree with Shaki saying she's not sure if he's a killer or not. Because beyond all this, there's something very suspicious with the way he presented himself during the course of the game as well. Like, in one respect, he's also been trying to almost get the blame on him by always adding those little mysterious things like, oh, just in case to prepare for that. Like, why would he say that, though, in the beginning?
Know.
And then there was something else early on he said that kind of, like, tipped me off, too. I'm like, but why would you say that out loud? Because that makes us suspect you.
If that's the case, that strange speech you made earlier, that was part of your plan, too.
Oh, yeah, like the bullshit he's been going on all trial.
You got us to lower our guard and tried to hide the fact that you did it, didn't you, you motherfucker?
Yeah, he is a dirty motherfucker.
Just admit it already!
Nagito, tell me you object to this. Frankly, I don't want to believe it either. We investigated together. You were so kind. I can't believe you're the one who killed Byakuya.
It is all a ruse. Everything he said to us so far.
Say something.
I think he's about to go mental.
Do we have to fight him with a blade?
Possibly that too.
What?
That's not a good sound.
Oh my god.
Yep, so I'm guessing he's one of the ultimate despairs, actually.
The ultimates are working together to combat the despair of their friends.
Yep, I guess so.
How wonderful. How beautiful it is. Huh?
Those eyes don't look very human. At that moment, Nagito's eyes, the darkness in his eyes shone brightly. The darkness in his eyes shone brightly? All right. Sounds like a contradiction. As if layers upon layers of darkness were folding into each other. Maybe he is Makoto's, nobody or whatever after all. As if hope and despair had been crudely mixed together.
Let's cut to the chase. You're correct. It was my doing all along.
Okay.
Huh. I'm the one who
once again, one of the gray aliens.
Before the party started.
He admitted it.
What? I have to say, I do think he did that.
Find my way to the table in the dark.
And that. I agree with that.
And of course, I'm the one who caused the blackout.
Yeah, that too I agree with.
After all, there's no way I'd knowingly whip out a knife in front of everyone, right?
Well, I don't know. The way you're acting right now, you might do something crazy like that.
Is it just me, or does he seem a little nuts right now?
It's not you this time.
But I never expected Byakuya to have night vision goggles.
Then well, how did you expect him to get over to you?
To be honest, that was a little extreme. How did you know to bring the goggles, of all things? But whatever. I guess, like a Boy Scout, he always comes prepared.
Because of that, we had ourselves a little scuffle under the table. And, well, we all saw how that played out. But with a twist ending like this, I think we can all agree this ended up being a very interesting mystery.
I think he's skipping over something here.
Byakuya performed admirably. Just stop it already! Seriously! What the hell happened to you?
Don't tell me. Is this your true nature? Were you lying to us this entire
true nature.
Time?
Lie? That's outrageous! There's no way someone like me could ever lie to you guys.
Well, what would you call what you've done so far?
I understand better than anyone else that I'm ultimately worthless.
Huh?
What? The ultimate worthless person? Is that what he actually is?
I'm too arrogant to have dreams or cling to hope. I'm too disdainful to actually try at anything.
Well, he sounds kind of a bit like Junko, the way she was acting in the end.
I've made peace with the fact that I'm a lowly, stupid, insignificant human.
So much more self-loathing, apparently.
She didn't hate herself.
She kind of just, like, basked in it.
The type of guy who spent his childhood killing neighborhood pets!
Yeah, it does sound like that kind of guy, I guess. Just a total, what's the word? Like a psychopath or something. He just doesn't feel emotions.
He seems like the sort of person whose eyes light up while watching Friday the 13th. Just like me.
What? I don't think that's necessarily the same thing as enjoying a horror movie.
That's quite
time to bring it up.
This guy, is he the real Nagato?
Hey Nagito, if you were behind all of this, then did you also send that threatening letter?
Yep, I sure did. There's nobody else on this island whose handwriting is that painful to look at.
What?
What the hell? How did you write that way? So lazy.
But why would you send a threatening letter in the first place?
To threaten?
I think somewhere deep in my heart, I was probably hoping to find someone who would stop my evil deeds.
Wow, you have a penchant for the dramatic, don't you?
Well, I bet if that really was my reason, at least some of you would feel sorry for me.
Are you making fun of us?
By threatening Byakuya, Nagito was likely able to manipulate his actions.
There you go. Chiaki again.
Yeah, once again. Just hitting it out of the park. Then, how about that old-looking building near the hotel? Yeah, he really did set up pretty much everything in regards to this case.
Mm-hmm.
So suspicious. Well, if it's just cleaning, leave it to me. I'm actually pretty good at it.
In doing so, Nagito was able to manipulate everyone to the scene where the murder would occur. Am I wrong?
That reminds me. Nagito was the one who suggested I guard the office.
Yeah. That's right, because he told us to steer clear of the one room. Mm-hmm. And that was very suspicious. Yeah, and he was so busy cleaning the dining hall, he didn't have time to clean the storage room, supposedly. I think he was doing something else in there instead. If you stay in there for a long time, I think it would be bad for your health. In that case, why don't you guard this case in the office?
Oh, I get it. If Paco was guarding the storage room, Nagito wouldn't have been able to use the irons.
The threatening letter, along with all your suggestions, was all a trap to manipulate us.
Yep. That's true too, but you're wrong about one thing.
Oh, and you're gonna tell us what that is, are you?
Huh? What?
I didn't need to rig the drawing for cleaning duty, you know?
Really?
If that's true, then how did you conveniently get picked for cleaning duty?
But is it because he really is the lucky student after all?
I see. Well, there's no way I'd expect you to remember it. Talent for a worthless human.
I assume that was just a lie at this point, but I guess maybe it actually is. Or he's still lying now. That could also be it. Yeah, his talent is the ultimate baby face, really. Oh wait, I picked the wrong one. I wasn't paying attention. You're the ultimate unlucky student, right? Haha, I understand what you're trying to say. An awful talent like that is what I truly deserve. It's really close, but you're wrong. That is not my talent.
Crap.
Didn't someone tell us to choose babyface for something? Because it was funny.
Did someone?
In a comment.
Oh, well, why not? We already got it once already, so what the hell? The ultimate babyface. You're the ultimate babyface, right? Why the hell are you looking at me? Do you want to sleep with the motherfucking fishes?
Calm down. Hajime, don't say unnecessary things just to pick a fight.
That is good.
Crap.
I'm glad you remembered that.
Oh no.
Oh well. We took some damage, but we actually recover our health over time. Alright, finally. The ultimate transporter? What? What is he, like Vin Diesel or whatever? Was that Vin Diesel in the movie?
I don't think it was.
Oh, but someone else, wherever the fuck. Whoever the hell was in the transporter.
You're the ultimate lucky student. Then, did you? That's right. I just trusted my luck. I trusted I'd be picked for cleaning duty. You just relied on your luck?
He's like, dude, I trusted you.
It's true my talent sucks, but I'm still the ultimate lucky student, you know?
Maybe. Huh? I'm left with the red mark? I kind of think it's like even funnier if like we got the answer wrong 3 times. Like, no, we couldn't even bother to remember your actual ability. For someone called the ultimate lucky student, you don't seem very lucky right now.
But he was very lucky.
At the time, Hajime said I wasn't lucky. But it was actually the opposite. I was lucky. That's why I got picked for cleaning duty. Just like I wanted.
Wow, good for you.
Hmm.
Enough. I don't care about that anymore.
More importantly, why did you kill Byakuya? Answer me!
I didn't.
Byakuya was a very capable leader. For someone like him to get killed? The despair it brings.
Yeah, you talk an awful lot about despair for someone who isn't in the group. I mean, assuming you weren't in the group, that's just kind of a coincidence.
It's only
trying to say.
You symbols of hope should use his death as a stepping stone to shine even brighter. That was my only motivation.
Alright, sure.
You're not making any sense!
Fine, let's start the damn vote already. I'm ready to fucking kill this psycho.
Uh-oh.
Please, Monokuma!
Why are you begging Monokuma?
Please, wait!
Oh?
The autopsy?
Yeah, she's gonna put an end to this because of the size of the wounds.
He's right next to her.
How should I put this?
Just gonna like grab her and cover her mouth.
Is Magical
really the killer? What are you saying? He's already confessed, hasn't he?
I already know that, but there's just something a little strange.
There's something very strange about it. Why would he just confess?
If it's only a little, then keep your mouth shut. Your ugly face is stressing
no,
me out.
No, Hyoko. She actually has a point here. It's very important that we discuss this.
I'm sorry.
For now, might I suggest we listen to what she has to say?
Good idea.
But we know who the killer is.
Oh, Teru Teru. Can't gloss over this one, man. I'm sorry.
Simply listening is acceptable.
I'm glad it's acceptable to you, Gundam.
However, I won't allow this to end with mere play. Now then, let us lift the curtain for our bloody spectacle.
Oh.
What? Alright, a little easy there, Gundam.
Oh,
we
wait,
don't need
no
blood
ice.
To be shed just yet. Oh, there we go. Yeah, so I'll have to shoot that down too. Okay. I'm assuming this works the same as the last game. It's gentle, it won't appear at all, but we're on medium, which I don't recall the name, but it's not gentle. Oh, what? What's that?
Oh.
Really?
Hmm.
Oh, well, that's interesting then.
Why? Why won't we?
What if I try
to
shoot down? I'm gonna see what happens.
No, it won't work.
Well, I know, but I could shoot down with the A. Like, it's a different thing.
Oh.
So I'm just curious. Oh, it's all about. Oh, the autopsy results, obviously.
Mm hmm.
Yep, it doesn't do anything. Alright, I'll just sit back and watch this.
He has already confessed.
You know...
That bastard Nagito is the one who did it. He killed Byakuya with a knife he hit.
No.
No, that's wrong.
Oh, never mind.
Objection.
Thanks for wasting our time, skanky bitch.
Holy crap.
What the hell? Just because of all those like poses she gets into accidentally?
I guess.
Or is it an accident? That is the question. Hmm. Alright, well, we'll do it this time.
I think it's
the killer is so obvious.
He has already con-
you know.
That bastard Nagito is the one who did it. He killed Byakuya with a knife.
There we go. Luckily it wasn't
no,
in the way.
Wrong.
And here comes the twist.
That knife might not be the murder weapon. What you wanted to say, right, Nikon?
The hell are you talking about? It's obvious the knife was the murder weapon.
Look at Ibuki.
Based on the entry wounds on Yakuya's body, the actual weapon should be roughly 5 millimeters in diameter.
Yes, it's way too small for a knife.
5 millimeters in diameter? That's like way skinnier than a knife.
Yeah, that's basically what I said.
Hey, that better be true. If you screwed up, I'll sell your fucking ass to a whorehouse!
Whoa!
What the hell, Yuhiko? Jeez!
Not a whorehouse!
It's not the kind of businesses you're into.
Hey! Why are you threatening her?
Is this what you're trying to say, Mikan? As long as we can't prove that the knife is the murder weapon, we can't assume that I'm the killer.
Well, pretty much, yeah.
What are you saying? No one else can be the killer. It has to be you.
Hey, don't blame me. Mikan's the one who said it.
I'm sorry.
You're thinking about this too, aren't you, Chucky? She's going to come up with it.
That's her thinking cap.
Yeah, I guess it is. I think, you know, I was kind of wondering about this myself. I think she's going to become the version of Kyoko,
yeah,
apparently.
I was wondering if she had found the hidden passage.
Well, I think we know that Gundam did from him getting the earring back.
Oh, that's true.
So it's probably going to be discussed. What's interesting is even Nagito reacted to that.
Mm-hmm.
He was like, oh, you know what that means, don't you? So does he want us to discover who it actually is after all?
I don't know.
It's really weird.
Hiding?
Like, during the blackout, did something happen between you and Byakuya that we don't know about?
Maybe he actually does want us to find out it's Teru Teru? Because then we have one less person, well, two less people, because Byakuya's gone too. I don't know what he's fully trying to accomplish here. This is really weird.
Who knows?
After all this, what else do you intend to hide?
Jeez, the moment your back's against the wall, you get all silent. You piss me off! What happened during the blackout? If you cross your eyes like this, it gives you double vision.
Thanks for that information, Ibuki.
Great.
It's very helpful.
Our lives are at stake, you know?
Huh? Whose life is at stake?
Oliver.
Have you been paying any attention to Kane?
Seriously, how long is it going to take for you to understand the damn rules?
I guess you just won't.
Nobody can see in the dark. No matter how hard you think about it, the truth is beyond your sight.
Wow, it's really deep.
Don't you think that's a pretty clever metaphor? Despite the fact that it came from me?
Yeah, it's incredibly clever. Way to go.
That's not it. Not it. What's not it?
The truth is beyond our sight. No, that can't be it. There should be some way to find out what happened in the dark. It's what we heard.
Yes.
Is that what it's supposed to be?
I guess so. Ibuki's account.
All right. Trust that this is it.
Prove it with this.
Finger.
Even if we couldn't see what happened in the dark, I'm pretty sure someone could have heard it. Isn't that right, Ibuki?
For real?
Yeah, for reals. For show. Don't act so surprised.
You were the one who told me, remember? How everyone was shouting during the blackout?
Everyone, calm down. We gotta stay calm in a situation like this. Ah, don't step on my feet.
What the hell? What's going on here? This is...
Yeah. Also, I don't know if you noticed, but we also got a comment saying that that's not the original translation as well. Or it's not accurate.
Really?
Like, supposedly Byakuya said something more like, I can't remember what it is, because now I have a bad memory. I can't remember directly what I read. But something basically like, oh, like, what are you doing? Stop it. I think that's what it was.
Oh.
So, that I thought sounded like much more suspicious if Byakuya was aware of who he's confronting.
Definitely.
Or whatever.
Ow.
And then combined with Nagito saying that, it becomes pretty obvious.
Turn the damn lights on! I can't eat like this, you know?
You guys? Where are you?
Hmm.
Wasn't the blackout just in the kitchen?
As always, we have this little anomaly.
Perhaps the breaker overloaded?
Hold on a sec. I'll go along the wall and do something about it. Such perceptive hearing. Impressive. I'd expect no less from the ultimate musician.
It's a good thing your ears are awesome, because your face, style, figure, and personality totally suck.
So do yours.
Damn.
You've cut
what
me
the hell?
Deep with your knife of truth.
What is coming off her tongue?
However,
she is very interesting.
Byakuya and Nagito said in the dark.
What the hell? What's going on here? This is...
Ow!
It almost sounds like... Byakuya fought back against Nagito or something.
Well, that's actually what happened.
Really? Hmm.
As a sign of respect for Ibuki's talent, I have a small confession to make.
A small confession, you say?
I was actually shoved out from under the table by Byakuya. He shoved you out? Just as the blackout occurred, I hurried to duck under the table and grab the knife. But Byakuya, wearing his night vision goggles, caught me and shoved me right out from under the table.
Hmm.
That's right. I'm so incompetent that I couldn't even grab the knife.
But you weren't really trying to, were you? So Byakuya stopped him when he was trying to get the knife. And he got shoved out from under the table before he could even grab it. Well, it sounds plausible. I mean, just from listening to what they both said at the time.
What the hell? What's going on here? This is...
Ow!
I can interpret it like that. No, actually. Now that I think about it, that sounds like exactly what happened.
After getting shoved out from under the table, I was just as confused as you guys.
No, you weren't.
I lost sight of the glowing paint. And I didn't even know where the power cord was. Before I realized it, the lights had come back on, and Byakuya's body was lying under the table.
Hold on! Are you saying you're not the killer?
From the very beginning, the idea to throw a party, hiding the knife, setting up the blackout, it was all going according to plan.
Yeah, and you're trying to make us think that this wasn't part of your plan, but I think it was.
Mm-hmm.
But unfortunately, my plan failed. And all thanks to Byakuya's night vision goggles. What happened after that? Even I don't know.
You failed? Then you're not the one who killed Byakuya?
No, this isn't true at all.
Then we're right back to square one!
Because he actually didn't want to be the one that stabbed him, and he doesn't want us to figure out who it was.
We spent all this time talking back and forth!
Because I guess he thinks that he can get away with it, as long as, the person that actually did the killing doesn't get convicted. Because you have to get everything 100%.
Right.
What other word is brimming with so much despair? But you can't give up. You need to have hope. Do your best and move forward. Rising to the challenge again and again is why you guys are the symbols of hope.
What?
What are you going on about? Is Nagito really not the killer?
He reminds me of like the Mad Hatter.
Kind of. Is this guy really the Nagito I knew before? No, there's no way I can say that. I just thought I knew him, but this whole time I didn't know anything about this guy. I didn't know his true character. It's as simple as that. But now's not the time for me to dwell on that. We need to find Byakuya's killer by any means possible. Because if we don't, we will die here. Yeah. Oh, this might be the break in the trial.
Wow.
Yeah. Suspended. Damn. Oh, there's a little Monokuma and Monomi theater.
Well, now.
Now then, the class trial has reached its climax. But, okay, here's a question for you.
What's this?
To those of you who figured out who the killer is, how about you try out the Guess the Killer challenge?
Okay.
Whoever fails to guess the right killer will have their saved data melt away like butter.
Whoa, really?
But if you guess right, I reward you with $10 million.
Or billion even. That's with a B. Ten... Oh, this is you.
$10 billion?
Of course, for those of you who don't know who the killer is, you can just continue on.
Oh.
Let's guess.
Do you want to guess who the killer is?
Yeah.
I think I feel pretty confident. I'm pretty certain. Let's do this.
Oh,
what the hell?
Just kidding. You can't make a choice. There's no way you'd be able to guess who the killer is.
Yes,
I think
is.
I could.
And of course, there's no $10 billion either.
Aww. Well, I'd take 10 billion mono coins.
You're so evil.
That was evil. I was excited to do it.
Villain, you truly are a villain.
Yeah, he is. Alright, so I guess we'll save there. This is about, like, it's been about an hour and 20 minutes or so, maybe a little bit less, but that was about, like, the length of the first trial in the first game.
Yeah.
So it's interesting that's actually still going on at this point. I guess it is twice as long. So I think we will cut it here, because when we did the long trial in the last game, we did have issues.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll do half the trial now, and then we'll do the second half in another episode, so... It is nice that they have a break this time around. It's good for these guys' recordings. So yeah, we're reaching the exciting climax of the trial. Join us for the conclusion.
See you later.